Coming to Northeast Wisconsin live from the Civic Media Studios at the City Deck Landing in Green Bay and featuring TV and radio broadcast veteran John Maino, along with the City of Green Bay's longest serving mayor, Jim Schmidt. This is Maino and the Mayor. Here are your hosts, John Maino and Jim Schmidt.
Good morning. Happy Wednesday to you. Beautiful morning out there. Little rain overnight. 53 in Green Bay, 55 in Appleton, 58 Oshkosh. Winds from the southwest at 9 to 11 miles an hour.
Sweet.
Beautiful morning. What?
I want to check that because you...
From the west,
just
southwest?
For our listeners, the weather is accurate.
How many miles per hour did you say?
8 to 10.
It's from the southwest,
yeah.
So you got that.
Yeah.
Five.
Only five, okay.
Yeah. But it's supposed to be a little windy today,
yeah,
again.
Yeah, because the flag up on top, I base all that on the flag on top of the courthouse.
Right.
Yeah. When I walked on the side, I see the flag in the courthouse.
Yeah, that's what I do. Yeah.
I do.
Yeah.
That's how I get it. That's where I get it from.
I got it at 12.
12 what?
Miles per hour.
All right.
I mean, the flag is flying pretty good out there. I'll be honest with you.
So what did you say?
8 to 10.
Okay. It says 12.
Okay.
There whatever. That's close.
Yeah.
But close enough. I mean, it's you're more accurate than those weathermen we have on
stop.
TV. Okay, I just...
Stop.
Okay,
all right. That's all
right.
It.
Boom. You know what we're going to do in the morning? We're going to ask each of the meteorologists from every station to come in here at the same time.
I agree.
And we're going to let them beat the crap out of the mayor.
Especially Castro from Channel 11.
No.
The guy is like 6'3", 240, and he's a black belt. So I want...
Perfect.
Yes. So I want him in here.
Perfect. I have nothing against them. It's just that I'm jealous because they can be wrong.
Oh my!
Like 50% of the time.
Politicians
no, we can't.
Can't be.
We make a couple bad decisions.
Oh,
and we get held to pay.
Yeah,
so.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I'm jealous.
Yeah,
all right. Anyway, yes.
All right, fine.
Okay. You are. But John, you have zero training in
meteorology.
Yeah, that's the word I was looking for.
Yeah.
A little early, 6:08.
Yeah.
And you're pretty spot on.
Yeah. So I got another flat tire. Okay.
Yes.
So you didn't have it fixed?
No, I'm getting it fixed 9:30 this morning. I'm bringing it up to downtown garage here.
All right.
Oh,
okay?
Those good guys.
Great guys. And it's old school. It reminded me, honest to God, when I was just walking by it and everything, going up to it, it reminded me so much of like the gas station I grew up in. You know, my brother's gas station. I literally grew up in the summers in a gas station. So my brother worked there all the time. And that was a place to hang around and it was cool. And it's that old school smell to it of like grease and oil. And I just... loved it. It brought me back to like my youth. That's like old school gas station. I love that. But anyway, so did I ever tell you about, okay, so got to go to Madison this weekend.
Yeah.
Last time I drove to Madison, I got a flat tire right in front of my, it was during COVID and I met my daughter and my granddaughters at a school, a parking lot.
Uh-huh.
School was off. Brought them Christmas presents. And my daughter goes, Dad, I think you got a flat tire. And I'm like, sure enough, I had a flat tire. So it had one of those piece of crap, little winding kind of jacks, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That aren't
no,
worth-
I really don't, but yeah.
Yeah. And the tire iron, remember the old-fashioned tire irons? Those were a weapon. But remember, Cowboy Dave, remember those were a weapon, tire irons? And they were solid and, you know, iron. And now they're made out of, like, aluminum. They're these tiny little, like, aluminum things. And the last time I got my tires put on, the guy used the ratchet gun. Okay?
Oh, yeah.
So it was, like, welded on.
Yep.
Could not get it off.
Yeah.
Could not get it off. So there's a cop was driving through. I got a flat tire. I can't help you. There's a, you know, blah, blah, blah.
Whoa.
Okay, thanks. So I had to drive with the flat tire, ruining the tire, of course, to a quick trip type thing.
Mm-hmm.
Well, they don't have it, but at least then, you know. So I go in, I said, hey, are there any garages around? I cannot get this tire off. And she said, yeah, here's some names, some places. So I called two different places. Oh, I don't have anybody here, blah, blah, blah. So I call this other place. So-and-so's Martha's, you know, auto service or whatever, okay? Said, hey, listen, I need a tire iron. I said, mine is just this, you know, worthless little cheap thing. I said, I'll give you $20, I'll give you whatever you want if you just get somebody here and drop it off. The lady said, you're only like half a mile down the road or something. She goes, we don't do roadside service. I said, no, I understand. I'll do it myself. I said, if you can just bring me a universal tire iron, you know, one of those.
Right.
And I'll do it all. The guy doesn't even have to get out of the car, the truck. I said, just hand it to me. I'll hand him $20. He can sit there. I'll do it right in front of him and change my tire.
Okay.
She's like, we don't do roadside service. I said, I'm not roadside, and I'm not looking for service. How's this? I'll give you $40 to bring me a bleeping tire iron.
Okay.
You know what she said? We don't do roadside service.
Martha, that's why she calls the shots.
God, I'm not lying about this at all. I had my Facebook. So
you go up to 60.
A guy comes walking out. Elderly guy comes walking out with this, you know, truck and everything. I said, "Hey, you don't by chance have a heavy duty tire iron, do you?" He goes, "Yeah, let me challenge." So he said, "Oh no, these don't fit." He says, "You know what? But I think I got one at the farm." I said, "Oh, don't worry." But he says, "No."
Wow.
The guy drives to his farm, comes back with the universal. Helps me with it because we had to pound it even with a hammer. It was so, you know, stuck on. Helped me change the tire, the whole thing. I said, "Here, let me give you some money." He goes, No, I can't take money. I said, I took a 40. I said, I stuffed it in his pocket. I said, "I don't care if you want to give it to your church, to your kids, your grandkids, but I'm not allowing you to do all this work." And I told him that story. He goes, "What's wrong with people?" And I said, "You know what?" And I really meant that. I said, "Thank God a farmer happened by."
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
No doubt.
Yep.
If you're in need. A farmer, they could just do everything. Yeah.
Two words for that story, Johnny.
Yeah.
AAA.
I know.
You know,
I know. John, somebody else told me that.
AAA, I've had that forever. I buy it for my kids. You know, and there's also like discounts that you can get like on some other stuff. I never use that, but that's happened to me. And while you're going getting coffee, they come out and they change your tire and then you come back and it's all done. I ran out of gas one time. They send the truck or the guy to fill up your tank. And I don't know how much it is, but you want to get that. You should get that for your kids too. John, that's crazy. That's crazy. And look, that took 12 minutes to tell that story too. AAA.
Oh, sorry, it took 12 minutes. No, I tried to get it within 10. I'll condense it.
No, that's a nice service.
I know. I got to get that. I remember when I was going to school in Arizona, I had it because what they would do, this is old school, but they would give you like a winter route and a summer route. And they would literally be, they'd give you a map and it would literally be somewhere with like a yellow highlighter.
Oh, yeah, totally.
And they would show you the route.
Yeah.
And they'd even pick out like some possible hotels along the way and everything.
Now they have that. Their app, same thing.
Yeah.
They still highlight it.
But it was old school. Remember those maps? They give you an actual map?
Yeah. And yeah. Anyway.
Yeah.
When's your birthday? Oh, we just passed it.
St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe next year. Or maybe Christmas.
You'd buy it for AAA for me?
Maybe.
How much is that?
I don't know.
God.
No idea.
No, I don't.
Dave, how much is it? Wayne, how much is it?
You guys.
Nobody knows. What's wrong with you people?
But here's what I think. I think you buy, I don't know this, but. Well, I'm not quoting prices, but if you buy like a gold card or something, then the additional cards for family members is like cheap.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Got to get it.
So I might adopt.
Got to get it.
$20.
Got to get it.
Yeah, you do. Okay. Right. Anyway, yes.
Is that the only reason why you do it? Is because you'd save money?
Me?
Yeah.
For your kids?
The time. I'm not gonna go. Do you hear that story?
Does your daughter in Brooklyn have a car?
No.
Okay.
Neither of them do.
Mine either. I forgot. I was talking to some other guy yesterday about that. His daughter lives in Chicago and doesn't have a car.
No, they don't need a car. Parking your car is more expensive than rent is in Green Bay.
Yeah,
they don't need that.
You know what really gets you in the cities though is parking garages at hotels.
Oh yeah,
holy mackerel!
$50, $55
a day. Yeah, I know. So we got a big show coming up. We got Big Wayne in the house. We're gonna be bringing him in a few minutes. Julie Mazzoleni is with him. Talked about mindful spring cleanup stuff. And I want to get Chad on again from the Frank Lloyd Wright type houses from Cantilever.
Yeah.
His Facebook is awesome. And Wayne and I, we're going to talk about this because I'm getting to be more nature-like.
Okay.
I'm getting more in tune with nature. Uh-huh. And I don't rake leaves because I think it's.
The reason you're saying this is because you're starting to walk outside. That's like not getting into nature, but that's why you're saying that. But that's good that John's the first step. But you don't like. You're not big on recycling yet. I don't think you do a lot of yard work and we get the bees thing going because of Wayne, but I'm glad to hear that at your age, you're going to engage with, the environment. I think that's great.
Yeah. So I don't think people should, rake leaves because it's a great nutrient for your soil. It's a great nutrient for your soil. I don't think grass should be cut as often as people cut it. I don't think dandelions should be killed. I'm a firm believer in all those things because it's just better for nature. And look at Wayne. Wayne's giving a...
Yeah, but that's you guys who live out in the country can do that. But the city folks, we like green cut.
Well, they'll be green. Manicure. It'll be greener than ever.
No. I'm going to talk this No Mo May. She's coming in, right? That Julie? Is that what she does?
Well, no, she has other ideas for mindful spring cleanup.
Okay. Exactly.
All right. But I want to hear that. They just did our yard Monday.
What did they do?
Mulch, probably.
No, what's that? Aerated?
Yeah, and mulching.
Oh, that's okay.
Yeah.
Right. I think the yard looks great. No. And they didn't use that. You know, what else, what
about,
say,
hey, what do you think about a guy who says, my yard looks great? Oh, look at my car. Oh, my. Look at my. Have I showed you my dog?
I just want to say something about that.
I have the greatest. Whoa! We saw the greatest thing for Milton last night of all time.
It was pretty cool.
What? At the Art Garage. We went to this great open house at the Art Garage, which if you haven't been there, is a fantastic place.
It's right on Main Street, and it was
Cedar
free.
Street, kind of.
It's, yeah, kind of Cedar Main, right. You can get park on both sides. You're right, Cedar and Main. And they had this open house yesterday displaying, especially Naomi. She had a lot of really, really cool artwork. She does
Naomi
this, like,
that we had in here? I took a bunch of pictures for you to put on Facebook.
Yeah.
She took this one thing. She created this thing out of an old Bible, the pages of an old Bible. I got a picture of it. Was it Michael? I thought it was God.
No,
was it a picture of Michael?
There's no picture of God. No, it was Michael the Archangel, right?
Okay. And anyway, but I'll show you a picture. You're going to be amazed at what she created out of pages of an old Bible with this thing.
Very cool.
It was Michael under fire or something like that?
Yes.
Yeah.
But he was like, amazing. You know, the head of the angels.
Yeah. Anyway,
but it was great. And then she had a bunch of stuff there.
Oh, man. But they had this welding stuff. That's the main reason I wanted to go to see the welding art, which was really cool. And they're just students, or not just, but they're students.
Yeah,
right?
And it was pretty cool. They did just different pieces of chain and I don't know what that stuff was. And they just welded it together.
Anything.
Like
go
chair.
To a junkyard, grab a bunch of stuff, and create these cool things.
Yeah. That was neat. So that Art Garage, and I think it's open quite a bit. You just got to Google that. But the Art Garage in Green Bay, and we was really pleased with the attendance. I mean, I've been many times.
Oh,
there's a
my
lot
God.
Of people.
Was there a good cheese?
It was.
Oh, my Lord.
There was good cheese. We were kind of hanging around the cheese table.
It was the best cheese I've ever tasted. We kept going back.
Yeah, we did. It was really, usually you go to those things and it's kind of like, you know, not the greatest cheese and sausage. But
this incredible.
Cheese was, I don't know where they got
that. Where's
that
from?
I don't know. We got a call. Yeah. We went to your art. I think they're all excited. We're going to buy something. You know, we're calling back. We want to know where
did you get
the
cheese? It was fantastic.
We sure enjoyed that.
Yeah, we really did.
Yeah. No, that was fun. That was a great event.
Great time. So. Great place. And talk to them about, you know, if they got some kids, they got kids programs. There's a nominal fee. If there's kids that can't afford it, they'd love to go there.
Right.
We're paying for them.
Yeah.
We'll do something. We're paying. No, no kid who wants
cool
to go there this summer is not going to go.
Right.
All right. We got it. Oh, today is May Day, by the way.
No, I think that was yesterday.
No, May Day. It's the first day of May.
Jim. No, it's not.
Yes.
No,
it is.
It's always celebrated. May Day is always celebrated April 30th.
No.
No, I know, Todd. I'm just telling you.
No.
I think that was yesterday. In April.
Okay, guys, I thought today was May 2nd.
September. Okay. Big Wayne, Julie Maslin. We got a big, big show coming, folks. Stay with us. Todd's going to play all his own favorite music today, I think.
That's what I always do.
Hey, welcome back. Maino the Mayor here on 97.9 FM, WGBW, 98.3 FM, WSS, and the Civic Media app. Big Wayne is in the house right now, but first I have to talk about that thing about Milton, something you have to buy for Milton.
Yeah, I might.
It was this doghouse.
But okay. I don't like that, but...
No, but you could put it in, like, your,
right,
your
in the
bedroom.
House.
He would be, it would be one, it wouldn't be outside.
No.
It was a doghouse with a TV.
Oh, that's awesome.
The whole back was like a flat screen TV.
That's cool.
So what I was thinking, Todd, if we could get that, if we get that for the mayor, okay, and we could hook this up internet-wise or streaming, Milton could watch him all morning.
Yeah.
Oh.
And maybe we could go live.
And have a camera, vice versa.
Yeah, we could watch Milton.
Right. Yes.
Okay, hey, I'm open to that, you guys.
I thought so.
I'll put that in the budget.
Yeah, right. Sure. Tell Sage.
You ever see those houses, the older houses, which I think you live in, Mayor? You have that weird space underneath, like, the stairwell. I've seen people fix that up for their dogs.
Oh, I believe
with TVs in it and a little house. And, you know, it's like their little place to go.
Yeah, those are never wasted, little places under the stairs.
So it was storage, but now it's being turned into a grandkids, like, little room. There's a little plastic stove, and she's got some stuff in there.
Exactly.
Carpeting, a little light.
They love those little rooms.
That, and that's a little secret place.
Yeah,
yes,
that's awesome.
But that's a good idea. That's gonna be another probably 18. I got grandkids. No, it's gonna be a while. That's a really good idea to put it there.
I know. And you can have a camera in there to stream Milton.
I used to, everybody, every kid always like used to hang out in closets or stuff, right? I mean, you always like that certain space that's yours.
It's a secret. Yeah. Yeah. Milton's going to be like, you have to film me. I wonder what dogs do in private. Like, what do they do when you're not watching?
I'm not having a good day. I haven't gotten a perm in 3 weeks. He would be that way.
He's sniffing his butt. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
He's,
okay.
He's got manners. He's got manners.
We're not talking about the mayor now. We're talking about Milton.
Oh, we're talking about Milton.
Right. How you doing, Big Wayne?
Good. Hey, today?
No, you made a bold statement before we went on the air.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Yeah. Okay. So we're going to wait. I'm going to wait till Julie's here because, you know, to talk about details. But this is my goal today. I am going to win the mayor over, and I'm looking for his unofficial endorsement to my unofficial promotion.
Okay.
So that's what, when we leave, he's either going to shut it down or he's going to say, stamp approved.
And by him doing that, he's gonna like be with you, right? Yeah. I mean, really endorse it and everything.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Any hints, or we have to wait till Julie gets here?
Well, we can talk. Well, I'll give you some hints. So,
just by way of introduction, I think everybody knows you, but you are what do you call yourself? A naturalist?
Oh, it's a beekeeper.
Yeah, no,
I'm a naturalist.
I'm into the permaculture thing. So, meaning
permaculture. Never heard that before.
Me either. Oh, permaculture is a big keyword.
So, see those pictures of me when I used to get a perm.
Exactly. Yeah. So permaculture is this concept where you instead of purchasing inputs in your farm or lifestyle, you use the inputs around you. So meaning, like, for instance, I have gardens at my house. Instead of buying fertilizer, permaculture usually starts with some type of an animal. So my chickens, yes, they give me eggs, but honestly, the biggest investment that they have to me is the fertilizer. Because if you're doing organic gardening, to be honest with you, it doesn't even pay off. It's so expensive. If you're filling a raised bed with organic soil, oh my goodness, it's like $20 a bag, and you're going to need like 20 bags. It's like you can never recoup that cost. So permaculture is that. And then, so it's using cover, or like, so instead of going to buy, you know, straw, I use leaves for cover and things like that. So permaculture, and that's the concept of, so in my backyard, the things that are most important that you're going to visit most often are closest to your house. So my garden beds are literally 5 feet off my deck. So because I'm visiting them all the time.
Did you see that rabbit that got into mine? Did you see that picture? That thing is 4 feet off the ground. Now I realize it got up when there's a patio step. He went up on the step and then jumped from there.
Yeah. So anyway, that's where I come from.
Basically. Permaculture. I'm with Johnny. I haven't heard that term. Is that like minimalist? Is that starting to grow now, or has it been around forever?
Oh, it's been around forever.
Okay.
Yeah. Permaculture is just, it's kind of like
living off the land.
Sustainable agriculture. You've heard of that, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So it's the same thing. It's just like beekeeping. So, you know, I've learned pretty quickly that beekeeping sometimes can. So that's the thing. My wife and I want to live a more sustainable life. And so I'm like, hey, we love honey because she does a lot of baking and everything. So I'm going to get some hives. My dad did it. So very quickly, I'm like, this isn't very sustainable, but there's practices that we can do as beekeepers to make it sustainable, meaning raising our own queens, having smaller hives to feed our bigger hives, you know, things like that. But so sustainability is just trying to have some type of a lifestyle that you can continue on with a minimal input. Using inputs around you.
I want to be the same way.
I don't think I do.
Yeah. So why?
It sounds. I don't know if I like it.
I love it.
Hey, exactly. So
I love it.
That's why I'm here, because I've worked with people like the mayor before. I work with very wealthy people. So today is May 1st, right?
Yes.
And what has been the last couple years that has really grown people that has, is just like the mayor is like, oh, I don't want to hear that term anymore, is no mo may.
Right. Right.
Like no mo may. So in fact, no mo may, you know, we're changing the verbiage because some of the science behind it has been kind of retracted and so forth. But what we want to do is, and especially for myself, is I want to help the pollinators, because honeybees are important to me. But the pollinator, the other pollinators, so honeybees is a livestock. We consider them a livestock. So kind of take them out of the equation when we're talking about this, because we are managing the majority. Well, I can't say the majority, but the bees are considered large because we're taking care of them. We can make them sustainable by making queens and everything, but it's the pollinators in nature that we need to watch out right. for. And what the reason why for bees is because bees use pollen to keep their hives healthy. So they're not real picky about where they get their nectar from, but they are with pollen. And so we need biodiversity in everywhere. And so, you know, what's happening is we're taking away from, you know, all the landscaping of the yards. We're taking away that environment for these pollinators. So they're on their decline. That's the number one reason why pollinators are on the decline, because we're taking up their space and we're making it sanitary.
But is grass isn't a pollinator? Is it?
No.
Well, then what? Well, I don't get the connection between no mow May and what you just talked about.
So no mow May came from is they kind of went the complete thing. So the
concept, went to the extreme.
They went to the extreme. Yeah. So what? So basically, we'll have Julie, or she'll talk about this, but 80% of the insects, the pollinators, they hibernate, they overwinter in the ground. So generally speaking, late April, early May, they're coming out of the ground. And what happens is either two things, either the newly mated queens of the bees or the insects overwinter in the ground, and when they come out, then they start their colonies, and then they lay their colonies before. So they're coming out of the ground. So what we don't want to do is spray pesticides. We want to try to keep.
Why do they? I didn't know they spend winters in the ground.
Me
bees
either.
Do.
Yeah.
What if they spend them in their hives?
Solitary bees.
Why don't they just stay in their hives?
Right. Honeybees do. So we can get into that.
Wow. All right. Big Wade's in the house getting an education today.
Yeah, we are.
Ben and Deanna Malker will be joining us. Gizmo will be joining us. Aaron Popke of the Packers will be joining us. Big show. Stay with us. Back after this.
Civic Media app today from the Apple Store or Google Play Store. And text the studio directly, all from the Civic Media app. Download it today. Now, once again, here's Maino and the Mayor, John Maino and Jim Schmidt.
Hey, thank you very much. Welcome back. Maino the Mayor here on a good-looking Wednesday morning. Today is also, today is May Day, obviously. It's also Skilled Trade Day.
Nice.
If I could go back in time, I would do that. I would go right from high school. I'd go into like a community college or vocational school, and I'd get a skill.
You kind of have that.
I've never had it.
You do a lot of woodwork. You do welding.
But I've never done training. And I'd love to we've run that commercial. I wish I could go to that. I wish I'd start over again, be 18 or 19 or whatever. And that thing, that commercial we run for that apprenticeship.
Yeah.
To get the carpenter's union.
That is cool.
Man.
Yeah. But you know what? I was thinking about you last night when I was coming home from that.
In a good way? I'm never hanging out with Maino again.
Yeah, well, I think about every day.
Because whenever somebody says Maino, I was thinking about you. I never know which way that's going to go.
That would not be a unique thought. Yeah. No, this one was. So we were at the art garage.
Okay, last... say one thing to Todd, because I want him to write this down. 226.
What's 226?
226.
Nice.
Write it down. 226.
Why? What was that about?
Weight-wise.
Oh.
Todd's charting it for me.
That's good.
I know. And that's, so Todd's my guy.
Well, he's my guy too.
Well.
We trust him. He's keeping track of that.
Yes.
No, last night we went to the art garage, and across the street from the art garage is the Artisan Center by NWTC, making stuff by hands. And they had classes going on last night, so we couldn't go. But I've been there, you know, a gazillion times and spoke to the students and the faculty there. But this is what I think, this is my suggestion for you. I think you should go and take a class, and I think you'll probably breeze through it because you do like doing that. And even last night when you're commenting on some of these pieces of artwork, I was like, wow, I didn't know that. I didn't know like it was even welded together. And then you should go back and teach.
Well, I can't teach anything.
Why? I teach.
No. You'd be a good teacher.
I think you'd be a good teacher, too. Yeah, because a good teacher fills in the silence.
Though. Well, it is. It's kind of funny, and they listen to you, and they're like, okay, that's cool. And then after, you have the patience to listen to a kid when he comes up with his excuse, and you'll be like, okay, yeah, okay. Because, you know, you've given every excuse on the planet. So I think you would be good at that.
Yeah.
Where did that come
He
from?
Did that thing again where build you up, build right? Up, and then rip it out from underneath you.
That passive aggressive, sorry.
227. 227.
226.
Wow. No, I just think that's something you should, because you always talk about, I'm looking for,
you know something that
you'd be good at that. I'm telling you.
I just read.
Trying to give you a compliment.
I've got a problem. I'm compulsive, I think.
No way, really?
Yeah. So when I do something, when I get into something that I like, it's like you give me a box of cookies that I really like, I'll eat every cookie.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm the same way.
Same way. Yeah. Okay. Same thing that you, when you discovered Suits and you watch, 10 hours in a row?
Yeah, I can't believe that, but yes. No, so, that's called a compulsive, addictive personality, that kind of stuff. Yeah. I have that because I actually got counseling.
But
on
I'm
that.
Really like that with reading. If I'm into something I really like.
Oh, yeah. You,
the other night,
all night.
Picked up that book the other day. I read it till 3:15 in the morning and then got 2 hours sleep, came in. As soon as I was done here, I went back and I finished the book. But it was such a phenomenal book. It was written by John Grisham. I love John Grisham.
He said that,
and it's the only nonfiction book he's ever written. And it's about this guy. He'd been a second-round draft pick of the Yankees. He was like the state player of the year, baseball and everything, but then just kind of flamed out. I mean, it really puts into context there. It's like even single A, like you go watch the Timber Rattlers or even these young players out at Rocker Stadium, they're really good.
Yeah.
You know, the difference between high school where you're playing versus these guys that are getting paid to play this game are really, really good. So he just didn't make it, okay? Becomes a partier, yada, yada. Long story short, this girl is murdered. This is in Oklahoma. And the DA was just, he had it out for him. And they manufactured, like, all the witnesses against them were jailhouse snitches. Like, I overheard him saying,
man.
And then all of a sudden this person's, thing, they're on parole now. I overheard him. The whole thing was based on that. So then finally they got DNA and he's exonerated, didn't do it, had nothing. But the only part I'm getting is that and he was on death row.
Wow.
He was close, like within a month of getting the needle, as they call it. Okay.
Yeah.
Two completely innocent guys. But anyway, bottom line is that put so much stress on him, being on and just being in prison and that whole.
Just a little.
Horrible.
Yeah.
But here's the part that just bugged me. It said he was 35. And he came out of there looking 65. And it's like, what's wrong with 65?
Are you 35?
What is that?
Are you really 35?
That's
the thing. That's what you get out of that story. I'm sure that was John Grisham's goal, is to have upset people about
what you got out of that whole book.
Jeez. Yeah. Okay, nice. Nice.
He looked 65. It's like, what's wrong with looking 65?
Okay, I think there was more. I think he wanted you to get more out of the book.
No, that's what I got.
Let me guess. The DA's still working?
Yeah, he is.
Yep, unfettered.
He is.
Ugh, those guys.
Yeah, he is. You got to read this. You can't. It'll make you
so
mad. There's
no control over DAs.
Yep.
Okay, that's a good book. I think I would enjoy that.
You would love it. His mom was dying, okay? And she wanted to do a video thing and saying, listen, I've got a diary. I write down everything. He was staying with me that night. A Blockbuster video just opened up. This is like 1982 or something, okay? And we rented 5 movies. And we sat there all night and we watched movies. He was there in my house. She did a videotape on this. Gave it to the cops. They threw it away. Didn't let the jury see it. Didn't let anybody see it. Isn't that something?
Yeah, that's awful.
So today is also a big day for you.
Oh, what?
Purebred dog day.
Well, I don't know. He's Milton. Yeah,
he's a purebred.
He's a Bernedoodle, but his dad is a... His mom is a Bernese Mountain Dog, and his dad was a full-size poodle. I met both of them.
Oh, I think it's a purebred.
Was that a purebred?
Is it purebred? Okay. I believe so.
Okay. It's still a purebred.
Is that a purebred?
It's expensive.
Could be. Wayne? Could be.
All right. How much was he?
It was a lot.
Yeah. I'm guessing he is.
Okay, let me ask this. What's worth more, Milton or my car?
Milton.
I think we talked about that. John, you can answer that.
Wow. His dog is worth more than... Although I will say, I was walking by that bike place the other day, and I saw some bikes that their price tags were more... And these are bikes, not motorcycles, worth more than my car. They were $3,000. Yeah. My car's worth $2,400. I got it appraised.
Yeah, I get... Milton would be two cars.
So. Today is also Lay Day. Is that the Hawaiian thing, the Lays?
Yep.
Okay,
yep.
Lay Day. It's high school or school principal day.
Now, isn't that nice?
Yeah. I didn't know.
That's a tough job. being a principal, I think that's a tough job because you got that faculty, plus you got the students and the discipline. I mean, that stuff all eventually ends up on your desk.
Principals and ADs, they're like, you know, I work with them. That's who I sell to. It's like every year you have to go back and find a new contact because they just get burned out.
They just get burned out.
They do.
But except for small towns.
Yeah, they stay there.
Well, because that's the best job in town.
Yeah, we had our principal. I bet I don't ever remember a different principal other than Dominic Giardi in my school. And he was just phenomenal. Great, great guy.
That's awesome.
I remember one time I got in trouble. This librarian hated me. And I used to be a little mouthy and whatever.
No.
But anyway, yeah. So I was screwing around with this kid. And I took a book and I threw it across the library at him. And she sent me right to the principal. She said, "You're coming with me, okay?" She says, "I want him suspended. I want him expelled." He threw a book across the
Expelled?
Yeah, well, you know, for, you know, whatever. She was, she hated me. She's a little hippie type. You know that new generation of people that were coming in and
change the world.
I'm a little hippie type.
Yeah, you are, me too.
You guys probably are.
And, and Dominic listens and he goes, "Okay." And I go, I didn't really throw it. It slipped.
It slipped.
I was like just
hand.
Screwing around and... And he tells the, he says, "Listen, I'll suspend John after one answer. I'm going to ask him one question. And depending on the answer, he's either free to go and I don't want to hear about this again, or he's suspended." He goes, "John, I think you threw that book. I just want to know one thing. Was it a spiral?" I go, "Yeah." He goes, "You're free."
Wow.
Honest to God.
That's cool.
And what did the librarian
do? Yeah, oh, was she mad?
Yeah.
Oh, was she? But she just noticed, like, she had the really short hair and the granny glasses. You know what I mean? One of those things. She hated me. Yeah. Wow. Also, today is school bus driver's day.
Shout out to
school bus drivers.
Oh, man. Mark, who I know, he's a school bus driver. I gotta tell you, the school bus drivers, they
need a tough job.
No, get this. These guys are trained. And I don't know if it's everywhere, but for sure in the city of Green Bay. These kids, that may be the first kind person they see that day. They may wake up in an environment where their people are yelling, "You're late," and all this stuff. And these kids, these bus drivers are trained to not just drive the bus. I mean, to really be compassionate to these students. And a friend of mine, Mark, does that. And he loves it. And those kids really respect these bus drivers today because they're good. They're nice guys. I don't know if you remember your school bus driver.
Joe Krutz.
I don't. But
bus number 11 with the Roadrunner sticker next to it. That's how
there
I found
you go.
My bus.
Everybody remembers their bus driver.
Big shout out to school bus drivers. They're awesome.
No question. I think that's what my, to tell you the story about my brother.
Oh, I thought you were going to say that's what you want to do.
No.
He's always got all these things he wants to do.
My brother, when he retired from the mine, he was a school bus driver.
Yeah. Okay. That's cool.
So he's driving down the road one time and this deer had just gotten hit. Okay. And the cops were there thing, and he goes, "Hey, anybody claiming the deer?" And they're like, "No, you want a poly?" He goes, "Yeah." So he ties up the deer in the back of the bus, but it kind of comes loose. And it's half dragged. There's a school bus driving down the road. This deer. They got some complaints about that.
I guess.
Yeah. So anyway, there's a school bus with this dead deer dragging. Anyway, birthdays today. Tim McGraw. Love Tim McGraw. And Ray Parker Jr. What was Ray Parker Jr.'s one big song?
He had a couple, but...
Did he?
Yep.
But the big video was huge.
I have no idea. I don't even know
Ghostbusters. Remember Ghostbusters?
That was a big song.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my gosh.
That video was huge. The Ghostbusters? That was one of the all-time big videos. Don't you remember that? Ghostbusters? The original? Ghostbusters. Yeah. Remember?
I don't know. What year was that?
1983.
He probably never even went to Star Wars, the original.
I didn't.
Really?
I never saw a single Star Wars.
I saw the first one.
84.
84. Yep. Okay. Yep. Yeah.
A little bit. Well, you were too old for that. See, I was.
For Star Wars? I was like in college. Yeah. It's like, it wasn't a cool thing to do.
Okay. Yeah, well, that's great. So this Parker,
Ray Parker Jr.
A composer?
Ray Parker Jr. He was a singer.
Oh.
I ain't afraid of no ghost. Remember?
No.
You remember that?
Yeah.
I'm going to play it. I guarantee he's going to remember it.
I will. I just don't remember the guy's name. I mean, I don't remember everybody's name. I just thought that the video. Yeah.
Everybody remembers this.
Oh, yeah, I do.
Okay. Remember, I'm going down the road.
Yeah. I don't remember that, but I remember the song.
Do you remember the video?
I don't think I watched it.
Oh, man.
It was a white, hearse.
That's
yeah.
raised.
Yeah.
Exactly. Old ambulance is
right.
Ambulance,
right?
Yeah. There's a guy in Green Bay that's got one of those.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and I happen to know him a little bit. Yeah, it's so cool.
That's got to be from like the 50s, isn't it?
Yeah, it's old.
It's cool. I love those.
No, I swear to God, I have not seen that, but I did. I recognize the music.
Yeah. Oh, it's great. It's a great video. So, anyway.
All right. He's 70 today?
Yes. Yes. Tim McGraw was starting to become an actor, and he was good. He played the dad in The Blind Side.
Yeah.
Remember that movie? Yep. Great movie, but he played. Boy, that guy has turned out weird, though.
Oh, man.
Have you read about
Unbelievable.
That?
Unbelievable. And
the guy that was portrayed, you know, the guy that played that for a long time in the NFL.
Didn't he come around?
Well, he's trying to sue them for like $50 million or something.
But didn't he come around? Didn't he say that was kind of. Didn't he come around and he's back to like. Look,
normal again?
I was kind of a. I didn't mean to be such an asshole about this whole thing.
Oh, wow. Okay. I think that's $10 fine.
I'm going to make it 20.
I agree.
I just think the guy was. He really turned on his adopted parents.
He did, yes.
Like big totally time.
Did. Big time.
And
but then he tried suing them for all kinds of money. And they're like, We had this agree. We set up this fund. It's been funneled right to you.
We're not taking a dime.
I don't know how he said that word.
Well, no, I just think it's really sad.
He caught himself too.
I did.
I think he's back at a city council meeting.
Maybe
$5.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah.
No, I really think that was awful what he did.
I agree.
Those people gave up a lot.
Absolutely.
And they did it for him. They said, look, what is it called?
Conservatory.
And he was like, yeah, this works because you can. And but I got to get the end of that story. I'm not sure how that ended. I don't think it ended as bad as you think it did.
I don't know. But he came off as just a bad guy there for
really
a while.
Really bad.
Really bad. Yeah. But Tim McGraw was great in that movie. I don't know why he stopped acting. Yes. Wayne, were you an actor in high school? I could see you as an actor in high school.
I try. In 4-H, I did.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and what happened is it was funny because I was probably 12 years old, and I had a big part, and I forgot a line, and I, like, jumped ahead, like, a page.
Oh. And then everybody looked at me like...
the whole cast off.
Yeah, everyone's like, well, what do we do?
Nice. Nice.
I can see Wayne at 12. 6'2", 220. Yeah. We're going to other kids.
We're going to skip that whole part.
Had a beer.
Kids are practicing all night, and they just were skipping all that.
Well, you guys had a quick break. Julie Mazzoleni will be joining us. Ben Indiana Malcor, Gizmo, Aaron Popkin of the Packers. Back after this.
If you're seeing things running through your head, who can you call?
Ghostbusters!
An invisible man sleeping in your bed. Ow, who you gonna call?
That's my fault.
Oh, okay.
Cha-ching.
ten bucks from Todd.
There you go.
Okay. Thank you very much, Todd. Hey, welcome back. Maino the Mayor here. Big Wayne in the house and a very special guest that he brought along. Or invited. I didn't say brought along. Invited.
Yes.
This looks like a game show right now. You look comfortable in that with that.
I know the handheld. Yeah. I am. I'm a lot more comfortable with the handheld. I really am. Yeah.
Hey, so you know, I remember one show you said, how did Wayne learn to about bees so fast? Well, obviously, you know, I'm like you. I got a crazy obsessive personality.
Yeah.
But it's because of knowing people like Julie here. So I'm bringing in the big guns today for the mayor. Now, Julie, we've got a big job ahead of us. So you're just the fact. You're the facts person. But the mayor here. So and Julie,
mayor and mayor. You're mayor, right, Julie?
No.
Oh, he was teasing.
Oh, I thought I thought you really were mayor of Chain of Lakes.
No.
Or
Chain of Lakes.
Well, basically, she is.
Yeah, but okay. She has that. She has that.
But you don't
Aurora.
Actually get elected. Don't run for election type thing.
I do not.
Okay.
Run for
okay.
Election.
Wait.
Just nominating.
She's the go-to guy in that community.
Yeah.
Okay.
So,
person.
So anyway, Julie's going to educate us about, you know, protecting the pollinators, how we can be more mindful and cleaning up and everything. But, you know, I'm the marketing guy. So at the end, like we talked earlier, I want to try to get the stamp from the mayor and everything.
From this mayor.
Of this one, not great. And I'll talk to the existing one.
Yeah.
So what we're talking about, the reason you're in here is I was not a huge fan of No Mow May. And I get the whole environmental thing. As I was telling Julie during the break, yeah, we started a sustainable task force when I was mayor, a lot of it had to do with recycling.
Hang on one second. Salute! Every time he says when I was mayor, we take a shot.
Okay, it's been a little while.
I was wondering what was happening.
Okay, so was I. But then that really worked. And there was a lot of things, water consumption, bottled water, just a lot of little things. But then this whole No Mow May, that really started stronger in Appleton, didn't it, than Green Bay?
I think
it started in Appleton, to tell you the truth.
Thing. Yeah. I remember that. And it's like, and Appleton's got it going on. And we're like, so we looked to them and they're like, let's do that. Well, some of the neighborhoods, you know, they look really nice, but then one house looks like it's vacant, you know?
Right.
And some neighbors don't like that, but they don't want to complain because they want to be neighborly because you got to live next to this person or on the same block as this person. So I never really embraced that like I probably should have, although I'm okay with that. But you've got some other suggestions to help us.
We do, and I think it's more than just No Mow May. No Mow May was, I think, misunderstood by a lot of people. You could see people leaving the dandelions in their yard, but then they'd go and spray the dandelions with pesticides,
which is terrible. And I'm all about
herbicides
that.
To try to get rid of the dandelions. Well, the fact was we needed the flower. The pollinators needed the flower of the dandelion in order to feed. They're the first flowers that come out, and our early pollinators need early plants, early flowers, so that they can have some food. So when they come out of hibernation, so that's really what No Mow May was all about.
And did you know that dandelion greens are one of the most nutritious things you can grow?
They are.
They're the most nutritious thing you'll find.
John's a naturalist. Well, he just started today.
Well, my grandma used to make dandelion wine.
Right.
And we used to eat the dandelion greens. So
she also did time. So I just
not the other one.
The other one. Okay. But who? Okay. So these dandelions come up early, and some people don't like them. But you would encourage them to leave the dandelions and not spray them. I just want It's for the bees?
It's for bees. So we have our other pollinators. It's not just bees, but all of our pollinators. Many of our pollinators they hibernate. And so they're digging down into the dirt, into the ground, or they're in our stalks, our pithy stems and stalks of plants, and they need food when they come out of hibernation early in the spring.
Just tell me, and we'll move on. But what else is a pollinator? I know what a bee is, but what else does that?
Most people know about honeybees, right? Honeybees, but the honeybees are not the only bees that are out there. We've got over 400 different species of bees here in Wisconsin alone. But other pollinators are like butterflies and moths are really important. There are nighttime pollinators. And, you know, wasps and beetles and ants are also pollinators. So they have a little harder time because you have to climb up on top of them.
All right. That's good to know. All right. So I we need all of those things, especially butterflies.
So just to kind of reiterate. So honeybees overwinter as a colony. They're a super organism. So they're in hives. They're in trees where most pollinators, I think 80% of them, they hibernate underground, either like newly mated queen or they lay their eggs, they have young underground. So that's why in May we have to be careful of how we clean up to protect those. So,
and let's remember our honeybees are not native to the North America. They were brought here over in the colonial days. It's our native pollinators that are here that we really need to take care of. Honeybees are not in trouble. They are not endangered. And
see, that's what I thought when they first came out with the No Mow May. Like, they're endangered and we're killing too many of them and stuff.
Save the planet?
Yeah.
Well, and honeybees have been a big red flag. So when the mites came in and we started having issues with a colony collapse disorder, a big flag went up. Though something's happening with our honeybees, and they are dying faster than they should be because of the diseases and the viruses, and because of mites, and
because of what?
Mites.
What are mites?
That's a whole nother topic. It's like a wood tick.
They're right. It's like a bee on a. It's a bug on a bug, basically.
Okay.
Mites are what's.
Can you see a mite? I don't know what a mite is.
You can see them, but they're so tiny.
Can like no-see-ums, Wayne? Remember no-see-ums?
Sure.
Don't you? The UP, that was the big, that was the worst thing were no-see-ums because they were so tiny and they would bite your ankles and stuff so bad. It was incredible. But you didn't feel their bite. And then the next day, your legs would just be crazy. We don't have no-see-ums around here, do we?
No, I don't. Do you know?
Todd, do we have no-see-ums?
I don't think, I think they're southern.
Well, we have, well, I I think they've got a different name for them in the far south, but the UP is notorious for no-see-ums.
I have no idea.
When you drive to the UP, Wayne, there's No-See-Um Creek outside of Escanaba.
I know there's Ford Creek.
Right, it's right by Ford River. It's right by the Ford River. No-See-Um Creek. No?
Down in this different name, Nassiums.
Oh, is there?
No, I'm just kidding. Down in the south.
Anyway.
All right. Todd, have somebody text me that knows what a no-see-um is, please. Does it have a different name to it? Okay, I'm sorry, but go ahead.
All right.
So I think that's what a mite might be.
Go ahead. What? Where the hell are we?
Yeah.
Where the heck are we? Sorry.
Are you Italian, Julie?
I'm by marriage.
By marriage, yeah.
Yes,
nice.
By marriage, but okay. Not.
Because we got Mazzolini's in this in Green Bay.
Yes, we do. I'm married to one.
Oh, you're all.
She just said that.
Not Paul.
Yes.
You're married to Paul?
I am. You know Paul?
I knew him. I knew his dad.
Yes.
Oh, my God. Good friends.
He told me to ask if you knew
him. Oh, my God.
Gas station on South Broadway.
He was best friends with Vince Lombardi. Remember I told you that?
Absolutely.
In fact, I told Jim yesterday. I said, I wonder if there's any relation to Mazzolini's that owned the gas station that used to take care of all the Packers' cars. Morning of the Ice Bowl. Unknown story. He went around and had to jump a whole bunch of Packers' cars because cars wouldn't start.
My father-in-law?
Yes. Yes.
Interesting.
Oh, we got to set a quick break. Julie, stay with us. Right. Back right after this. Oh, I could give you back.